Hey everyone, in today's video I'd like to share with you some behind the scenes footage that Ben and I captured while taking creative portraits of Charlotte. I will then take you through the steps I took within Photoshop to take this raw into this edited photograph. So as you can see, we used a single light setup to achieve a beauty-like result. I'll be posting the photographs that we took throughout this video. Okay, so we are inside Photoshop CC 2019. I'll quickly show you the before and after. Before and after, before and after, before and after. So up until this point, I have made minor adjustments inside Capture One. I just want to say this is not a tutorial as such, more a walkthrough of the steps that I took inside Photoshop. As always, skin retouching and editing photos is highly subjective. These are just the steps that I like to take. So first of all, I noticed there's this huge space at the top of the image. We have a great opportunity to frame within a frame here. So I just duplicated the image, inverted it, and then masked back in the window pane. So before and after, before and after. We then head into the face just to do a minor cleanup of the skin. Before and after, before and after. So we are just removing minor blemishes and flyaway hairs. We then use a method called local dodge and burn to retouch the skin. So before and after, before and after. This method just increases and decreases the exposure of the skin using curves. And then I used a method called frequency separation just to clean up a few skin tone issues. These were mainly caused by shooting through a window. You can see down the left hand side here, we have these white highlights. These are quite common when shooting through windows without using a circular polarizer. So before, before and after, before and after. Let's just take a look at the retouch as a whole. So before retouching and after, before and after, before and after. Then we move on to my favorite stage of the editing process, that is color. So before coloring and after, before and after. We then move on to global dodge and burn. Again, this is a method of adding and decreasing exposure. In this case, I've used curves. So before and after, before and after. I'll just zoom in a bit closer once again. So before and after, before and after. So that's the steps I took to edit this image of Charlotte. I'd like to say a big thank you to Ben, who took the time to record the footage on the Fujifilm X-H1 camera, and to Charlotte for being an incredible model as always. If you have any questions regarding this edit, please leave them in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, I'd love to hear them from you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.